The biggest secret in the universe. The biggest secret in the universe is this. Whatever happens in your life is there to help you experience more love. Grasp this and you understand all else. What follows is why this must be true and how you can use this wisdom to change anything. Have you ever noticed losing interest in a project after a few achievements? Have you ever become careless about money after getting a lot? Have you ever begun losing romance after getting him or her? Have you ever noticed treating people you already know worse than new people? And have you ever noticed companies that become bigger and stop caring about their customers? These patterns of decline are very common in society. Decline of love after success is the main cause of decreased health, happiness, and wealth. Spiritual law is that you will experience in life whatever helps you experience more love. So if abundance causes you to experience less care or interest, then abundance will be taken away from you again. Why? Because the universe conspires for you to experience more love. And this is how most people's finances, health, happiness, etc. go up and down over the decades. They don't care, so it all goes down. So they start caring again, by necessity, and it all goes back up. Then they're well off again, become complacent, and it all goes back down. Then they wake up and become attentive again, and it goes back up. If only losing money, health, relationships, or happiness makes you more aware and loving, you can be sure that you will keep losing them. It means that the only way to make you more loving and aware is to take something away from you. Would you like to break through this pattern and become healthier, wealthier, and wiser than ever before? Then let improved situations cause you to become even more loving, interested, and attentive. Let success inspire you to become even better. When abundance makes you a more loving human being or helps you maintain interest in your friends, family, customers, etc., more abundance will come to you. If there's any area of lack in your life, look for a lack of care toward yourself or others and correct yourself. Does this remind you of parent-child relationships? That's because our relationship to the universe is similar to that of a child to his or her parents. We like to spoil our children with unlimited generosity, but if this causes them to become spoiled and unkind, then it seems like the only way to make them caring, respectful, and aware again lies in no longer spoiling them. So we then intentionally throttle back the flow of abundance in their direction. But this can't be true, Fred. What about all the rich, famous, healthy, happy people who are unkind and just outright nasty? Their riches are temporary, and their happiness is an illusion. If you think these outright nasty people are happy, healthy, or wealthy, then you're seeing only a snapshot rather than the whole movie. Or they're creating a public perception of their supposed abundance. Abundance equals rich and happy, not only rich. And they're hiding their suffering. I've met a lot of people from all walks of life over the last 40 years, and it's been easy to see where abundance is authentic and stable, coming from love, or where it's temporary, or at the expense of health, coming from trickery. And then there are some very kind and loving human beings that are mistakenly viewed as evil by the public. In spite of appearances, there is no nasty person who is at the same time abundant. This false assumption is rooted in conspiracy theory, which itself is rooted in the paradigm that the universe is an evil place that rewards evil. To get a bigger picture of this, look at people's lives when they are older. Above the age of 70, they draw closer to the end of the movie of their life, and their conduct throughout life becomes more visible. Loving conduct guarantees long-term happiness, health, and success. Unloving conduct will eventually catch up with you and leave you lonely, poor, or sick in old age. But even then, it's never too late to turn it all around. Is it controversial to suggest that people end up where they are, primarily through their own choices in life, rather than being victims of uncontrollable circumstances? Then I'll soften this stance a little by adding that many people are not entirely conscious of the process. I make such statements not with the aim to judge or condemn people who are suffering, but rather with the aim to help, so that they may become more conscious of nightmares of their own making. Another way to get the idea is by looking at people whose success stories have spanned across their whole lifetime versus people whose fortune was short-lived. The difference between one-hit wonders and those of a lifetime legacy is that their fortunes did not fundamentally change who they were inside. They never gave up their creativity or love, didn't sell out or compromise their dignity and honesty. Fortunes come and go easily, but it stays with those who stay true to themselves. And being true to yourself means living from love. No doubt we all experience our share of trouble and challenge, but if you take the challenge as an opportunity to grow in awareness and love, the trouble is short-lived. If the universe is a friendly place, how could it be any different? It could only be untrue if the universe were a mean place. Honestly, how do you think nasty and unloving behavior will be rewarded by others? Eventually, the unloving will fall. This fact is evidence that the universe is generally built as a just and fair, self-correcting system. If this weren't so, we would all be extinct by now. If the universe were an evil place, then the mean-spirited would reap the greatest rewards. There do appear to be some realms of consciousness where the most evil person has the most power. In these places, victory belongs to the violent. But such parallel realities of drug cartels, mafia gangs, and tribal wars are not the majority on planet Earth's current level of energy. And their lives are not filled with joy, and they end just as violently. They live by the sword and die by the sword. If you wish to live in the friendly version of the universe, follow the rules of the friendly universe by believing that friendliness is rewarded. Reject philosophies and ideologies that imply that riches and accomplishments require force, cheating, trickery, and lies. Such beliefs have their basis in the unfriendly universe philosophy. The conspiracy theorist lives in this dark, reverse universe, in which the most abundant people are the most evil. Those stuck in victim consciousness insist that their experience in life has absolutely nothing to do with their own vibration, choices, thoughts, words, and actions. But there is a world in which love turns into riches of all kinds. I and many others already live in that world and have been living here for a long time. I've known this for 30 years now, and it's always guided and helped me without fail. But Fred, they say that money is the root of all evil. I've internalized this belief, and now you're telling me to love money? It's going to take some time for me to let go of that old belief system because it seems so true. Well, first of all, the saying is not, money is the root of all evil. The exact saying is, quote, love of money is the root of all evil, end quote. And secondly, it's not some unknown they who say this. It's a phrase from the Bible. Thirdly, I'm not saying to love money. I said love causes money. Big difference. Love could be the love of people, the love of your craft, the love to your customers, the love toward your children, the love toward your partner. In fact, the saying, love of money is the root of all evil, fits to what I'm saying here. Making an external thing, money, more important than the feeling and act of love is not only at the root of evil, it is also at the root of bad health, exhaustion, angry relationships, and poverty. Whatever happens to you in life is there to help you experience more love. I've met my share of people who have been seriously ill. As they became more loving, their health improved. But many, after their health improved, unfortunately went right back to being unkind, uncaring, and unaware. So what happens? They fall ill again. The lesson was not learned. Bad things happen until the lesson is learned. The lesson to learn in life is always the same, to love. Everything is a lesson in love. But if you stay aware, you no longer need lessons, just like an innocent person no longer requires punishment. An awake person requires no wake-up call. A well-intended person requires no guilt. And a person on a loving path requires no course correction. But Fred, love is not always the answer. I tried sending love to my boss who has really been treating me badly. He hasn't changed. He still shouts and threatens us every day. Sometimes he physically assaults us. In this case, self-respect, which is another form of love, is the answer. Do you respect yourself enough not to put up with that and leave the job? Yeah, but Fred, if I leave the job, I'll be out of money. On the contrary, without love, and here, in the form of self-respect, you will run out of money, happiness, and health. And does it get any more unloving than to think that you are unable to get a better job and have to put up with mistreatment just for a couple of bucks? The worldview shared in this chapter is not common. The objections to it are numerous, but once the philosophy of a loving and love-rewarding universe is embraced, most doubts subside, and peace and prosperity are what you become. From that time onward, you no longer need negative events to awaken you. Whatever happens to you in life is there to help you experience more love and awareness.